stronger anymore.
Yo, 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 what's up? Johnny Zuko sitting here with War Corpse. So, why don't you guys introduce yourselves individually, so...
My name's Cujo, I play bass.
I'm Rick, I'm a vocalist.
I'm Peppers, the drummer.
I'm Daniel, the guitar player.
That makes you?
You guys.
It makes you Rick.
I'm Paul, I play kazoo.
I'm just kidding, I'm Rick. I sing microphone, you know. We're just fucking. Paul. Please.
Guitar, rhythm and lead.
Cujo, I play bass.
Peppers, drums.
Daniel, rhythm and lead. So, you know, first off, how'd you guys come up with the name War Corpse? That sounds like a fucking battle cry, man. Like, what the heck? What's going on here?
Me?
Yeah.
I don't play Battlecraft.
Battlecraft?
Battlecraft.
No, I don't know. We were cursed for eternity in the beginning. Which was my idea, I guess. It was one of my lyrics. We were no initial importance of getting a name for the band. We just wanted to get out there. So we just came out with some funkified stuff that wasn't too cliche, I guess, you know?
And how would you guys describe your music?
Well, as most people call it, is metal. There's other people who call it groove metal. To me, it's just fucking metal. I don't know.
I tell people it's heavy metal.
Heavy metal, either way. I mean, it's metal. Can't go wrong with it. So,
you guys feel like you guys are like put in a box or anything like that when you go to shows and stuff like that? Like, do people misconstrue you guys as punks?
No.
Punk rock?
No, not at all.
You guys are just straight heavy metal.
Yeah, it's pretty much straight out heavy metal. I mean, there were some times where we played with black metal bands and they assumed that we were sounding like black metal. Those are the close-minded people sometimes. Yeah. But most of them are all cool. They hear us, they support us. Other than that, I mean, it's just a name, I guess, that kind of gives it out.
How long have you guys been together?
I believe y'all have been together for 6 years.
2009, pretty much. Me and Daniel got the band and started going on. Then picked up Rick, got Peppers, and then...
They kicked me out.
And then two years ago now?
You guys still having babies, man. I mean,
2 years we got this bass player.
On the second baby, he's like, hey guys, I'm pregnant again, dude. I'm like, hey, dude, all right, cool, you know.
Was pregnancy painful? Did you actually give birth? Did they give you a C-section or...
I mean, he had to go ahead and ask his sister.
Just in the wrong place, man.
Wrong place. Yeah.
I can imagine it's hard to be a band member with just one kid, at least. All you guys are parents, though, no?
No, I'm not. Daniel isn't.
I'm a daddy.
I'm a dad.
I'm a dad times three.
Daddy.
Is it hard to juggle the band and the family at the same time? Like, when you go on a road, is it really hard to juggle the two?
For me, personally, it's not. Since we don't have a band vehicle, per se, we cannot just hop in and go in one. We have to plan ahead where the show is, who's driving, do we have any help or assistance? And that, of course, takes its own, you know, if I'm going to take my family's car, all right, girls, I'm taking up your car for the night. You know, that's what it is, you know. Sometimes they'll take their vehicles and we'll accommodate. But as far as making family relations along with some music and stuff, it's, for me, it's just one big happy circle. Everyone supports everything, and everyone's taken care of at that point.
Yeah, mine's the same situation. Single dad, but a little harder, but I mean, either way, it's...
You hear that, boys?
It's
single.
Single. it's cool. I have family members that help me out, so...
Okay.
He's gay for me, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I heard him
once. For you, man.
He loves it because he's got snips.
And you, Peppers, like, how is it to juggle the two?
As long as the show don't fall on the weekend that I have the kids, it ain't no problem, man.
And when did you come into the picture?
2 years ago.
2 years ago.
Yeah.
And how's the band fitting? Is it like, do you feel like you fit with the band, or are you still trying to?
Most definitely, I feel. I mean, we all like to get together and have fun, and that's my deal. And we all sit down, we work on music, and it works.
And how long have you been playing bass?
since 2009. Yeah, man. I originally started playing guitar for a band called Acción Terrorista, and that.
Acción.
We lost a guitarist, and it was easier for me to find a guitarist, so I switched to bass, and I've been playing bass since. Again, I believe that's been since.
That's been since 2009, too.
Yeah. 2009.
Well, I met you guys around the same time,
yeah.
So.
You guys were all in the same circle, kind of? In the same group of bands?
Around.
Really.
No,
I was more Salinas. These guys were like Santa Cruz County.
Yeah. We've only seen him a couple of times whenever he comes to Santa Cruz.
Yeah, and that's how we met. And we played together a few times.
Yeah, we played a few times at the Blue Lagoon, and then we also played Skunk Fest with each other.
Oh,
too.
That's right.
Well, the main topic of the whole deal was needed a bass player,
yeah.
Needed backup vocals. We knew we could get a killer deal find a Mexican,
vocals.
Right? Because, I mean, these guys, no bargain, fucking
yeah,
to jump on board, you know?
So,
yeah, this guy was doing backups and he was doing bass, man. So,
yeah.
Yeah, and it's kind of a win-win because he doesn't smoke my weed, and I'm very happy.
And Daniel, like, so how long have you been playing guitar?
It's like 97 on and off.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Wow,
well,
I didn't even know that.
What made you want to pick up the instrument?
Metallica.
Deftones?
I just picked it up in class, Rolling Hills.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Oh, really?
With Pitter.
Oh, fuck, I remember that, dude.
That's where it first started, and thought I was awesome because I was the only one that actually had a guitar pick.
I remember that time when Doritos had the guitar picks. And I was like, oh yeah, I got a guitar pick for that class.
Like
yeah.
Doritos? Or?
The Doritos, yeah. Back in the day, they used to come up with Doritos, the fucking picks.
You use a Dorito for a guitar pick?
Yeah. No.
That's how that came across. All right,
fuck you guys. What I'm saying is that Doritos, they had a little guitar pick inside.
It's
I remember like, grabbing it from middle school, and I used that for that.
Dog, it's not a Cracker Jacks, bro. There's no prize at the bar.
Look it up, bitch. Look it up. All right? Just look it up. Back.
So, you guys have been together since 2009 with the exceptions of the new crew. So, when you guys go out lately to perform, how's the crowd reaction? Like, how does the crowd vibe to your guys' music?
We can get different ones.
Depends on the crowd.
Yeah.
We have depends on the crowds. Time.
And
the time.
How many people are actually there.
Yeah.
Fucking church party. Sundays, it's horrible.
Wednesdays
for the most part it's positive. The people come up and compliment the band, ask us about our instruments.
Yeah.
Occasionally the girl, not me though, just saying.
Bass is never good play, bro.
Right?
Never
just say
good. It's either the drummer or the singer.
That's cool, man. You know, we have a mutual respect with a lot of people who follow bands in general. We always kind of find out we run into people that are there for other bands, they've already been following two or three other groups, and they see us for the first time. And it's people you don't know what matters, and when they come face to face and tell you, hey, that's some serious shit. That's some serious shit. And they don't have to tell you anything. They can just keep their mouth shut and move on with their day, you know. But that's what makes us go further, man. We have people that really separate us from the rest of the groups as far as style. And that's cool. We kind of like that wave of energy we bring to the stage.
Yeah.
We're happy with it. I think we're all on the same page as far as that goes.
We do performing, dude. We all move. You know, he Trust does me, his does. You, this guy does his moves. You know, sometimes he steps on my fucking pedals. But other than that, he moves here. This guy, he moves. I mean, he's a drummer.
He's stuck back.
He's way in the back. Nobody sees him. But I mean, we perform out there. People like how we go on stage. You know, like there was times where I mean, like we got a good reaction where this guy bought all of us beers while we're still performing. He's going up to this guy. I think he was not singing at the time. He's like, I got
holding a 12-pack and shit, yeah. Individual beers.
Boom, right there in front of us. Like, you fucking guys are awesome. And I remember that. You know, that was, I remember we played at the Caravan, like, not too, like, on, like, last year, sometime last year. And this guy in front of me, he was headbanging. He was drunk off a freaking tall boy of Pabst. And he was, like, literally, I saw his eyes roll back up and he fell forward. Boom, fell right on my pedals. Beer.
You guys just cut your first feature length album, correct?
EP.
What does EP sound?
Extended play.
Can you explain the difference between an EP and an LP? So there's a lot of there's people out there that are confused and they think
you're
an EP.
I'm still not sure. So
I take care of all the legal stuff.
What is it?
As soon as you hit 8 tracks and above, it's an LP.
It's an official album.
So EP is anything
less than
anything
8.
Less than 8. Good thing they remember. If it was time,
we can't open a beer. That's not your part of him.
Hey man, watch where you fucking point your shit. Just like my fucking mouth.
You're one.
Okay. Are you guys actually gonna print out hard copies for the shows and stuff?
Yeah, definitely.
Are they gonna be free, or they're gonna have to do a donation?
No donation.
So like $5, you pay hours.
Give me the fucking money.
You call it a trade?
Hey, sucker.
No.
Trade some green for some...
For the other green?
That green too. I'll take some green.
That's his offer.
I'll take both greens for a CD. No problem.
At the same time?
Yeah.
How was it cutting that EP? Like, what was it like making that whole EP like happen?
I took no part of it.
Yeah, he wasn't there.
I was busy living the married life.
Making more kids.
Making more kids.
That's what she thought, right?
That's what she said.
Well, I think in my point of perspective, when any band's serious about playing out there and they realize, okay, we got to keep on marching, it feels great. Eventually, your songs, you want to get them compiled into a recording. And I believe for any band, their recording has to be great. And that's what we decided to do. We took some time, I think more time than an average band.
Yeah,
that's why.
To get some shit on tracks. But I think idealistically, we decided to get some of our better later jams onto tracks and get the great support out there.
Now, were these songs that already that you guys had not pre-recorded, but already had played before?
Yeah.
Then decided that you want to put them on the EP?
Most of them? Yeah. Most of them were already written out.
The last track is the one we're
last
working
tracks,
on.
Yeah.
The last half of the last track.
Yeah. Wait, so that the last song on the EP is like...
Continuous.
Huh?
The newest song?
The newest.
It's like 15 minutes.
15 minutes?
Yeah.
It's like 4 songs in one.
Pretty much, yeah.
Why so long?
Because we can.
Yeah.
Do it. I mean, I understand the creativity behind it, but like, were you guys just in a jam session, or just like, you know what, let's just continue playing?
No, nope. It's just something that I've always wanted.
Yeah.
And we ended up doing it.
We had a good story. We were able to expand that song very long.
But the idea was there before the lyrics.
Yeah.
What was the idea?
I just always liked the journey.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was his thing.
Yep.
And then you wanted to take the fans and the audience into that journey with you guys?
Oh yeah, if you hear the track, you definitely hear it big time. All the effort we put into that song, and yeah, it's 15 fucking minutes, but hey, it's a badass fucking track.
Probably won't be the longest.
Yeah, there'll probably be more.
There'll probably be more coming.
Yeah, we'll probably go for 18 minutes.
Oh, come on. We're going to do a double album. One track's going to be like 65 minutes.
That's the bull.
We're going to invent the flip the CD. Oh, no, it's already invented.
Flip the CD for the
side two.
It's called a record.
Yeah, it's called a record.
Side two. Ah! Are you guys going to be cutting out another album anytime soon, or are you going to take a break from this?
We'll be working on it soon, but it'll probably come out in about 4 years.
4 years?
Well,
maybe, yeah. Right now we're in the writing processes, and we're just writing up some new tracks just to keep it going.
How long did this EP take? Exactly.
2013?
Yeah.
right?
That long.
About
2016. In the middle of it, I had a prediction that it was going to come out February of 2016, and that's pretty much where we're at.
Still didn't happen, sorry.
We're
almost done. It's on SoundCloud, though. I mean, it's there.
It wasn't a smooth transition. We had issues with band members.
Yeah.
We lost drummers. And every guy that
bass players.
I mean, you know, we saw bass players, drummers. It was just horrible.
It's all their fault, man.
And we did it in a way that we shouldn't have.
Yeah, there's a lot of things for any band that we'll learn. You do something for the first time, you're gonna realize the second time, okay, well, this is what we don't need to do.
It's a good learning experience, So it's
some things they're out of your control. You know, losing members. Shit happens. So then we got to hit the studio, get the, you know, everything on dot, and at the same time focus on a new member.
And we're very picky.
Yeah, it's, we have no hurry whatsoever.
I mean,
I think
when you have 1,000 takes on a track,
yep,
with vocals, and recording solos over and over and over again, and I can definitely say I'm probably the most picky person here.
I think this guy's the most picky this one.
No, Daniel's the most picky.
Well,
when it comes to members or when it comes to songs?
When it comes to music.
Everything.
Songs, everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
When it comes to the time we practice, the time we
put it this way. When it came down to the final mastering of your product, me and him were the last ones tinkering, lingering around with the last details we want to change until I was like happy, and he was still not happy. So he's like, it's him. He's the most picky. He was the last one to be happy with the fucking. He's still not happy. So we released unhappy product.
Are you happy with the final product?
I'm good with it.
No, I'm not.
He's content.
He's content.
There are certain things.
If it makes you happy, it makes him happy.
Yeah,
that's it, pretty much.
It's hard work, but you know what? We're having a good time.
Yeah.
We have a great time every time we do get together for anything, let it be jam or a live gig or some supporting our local boys, some other bands. If three of us happen to go on night and support other bands that are in the scene, we have a great time even we're not playing, you know. It's just there's a brotherhood between us that's there before we even met each other. Only me and the drummer go way back. We have history. These guys, I have no idea who they were until we got into music. So
he's saying from his perspective.
Yeah.
Only you and the drummer go way back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like.
2000 and something.
Like you and Paul are go way back because you guys are family, no?
Yeah. We're cousins.
We sleep together. You're not real cousins until you sleep together,
right? I think that's the second cousin.
Hey, I didn't say fuck.
Are you just so right? Third cousin or second cousin?
Your brother's your cousin.
I'd say with a bunch of my cousins. You know me, I don't know about you.
I want to get it,
but
yeah.
I never slept with Rick, but I slept with his sister.
I don't even know where to go from here.
Brazzers what? Is more expensive?
Yeah!
You think Pornhub has way
more. This is
dude,
where I got the information
like $3,
from.
Bro!
And on camera, this is where I got information from, dude.
I'm sorry, bro.
Free porn.
Cujo at gmail.com. Base123 is the password.
Cujo on Tumblr.
I'm trying to log in.
Tumblr. Tender.
Oh, man.
You're gonna edit a lot of this bullshit out, right?